Does xylitol cause heart attacks?
Find out today on Medical History Mysteries.
I feel like everywhere we look, we find something that seems to be therapeutic for dental disease, but then it's unsafe. So the material du jour, I guess, is xylitol causing a heart attack. What is going on?
Well, when this study hit the airwaves, if you will, I knew it was going to cause a lot of ruckus in dentistry, especially because, you know, we are so likely to recommend the use of xylitol in treating xerostomia as a substitute, you know, for sweeteners and that kind of thing. I certainly understand why we love xylitol so much. But, you know, cardiovascular disease is still and remains the leading cause of morbidity and mortality, not just here in the U.S., but worldwide. And it's always ultimately about the platelets, right? And your ability to clot. Clotting is a good thing, but when platelets get overactive and can lead to thrombus formation, that contributes to heart attacks and strokes. So we're always a little leery of anything that can influence platelet activity. And that's how xylitol found itself in the crosshairs. So the study, just to give you the background, involved more than 3,000 patients from the US and Europe, okay? And it was done to perform complementary experiments using isolated human platelets. And we do this in dentistry. You know, we use platelet-rich plasma. Sometimes, again, whole blood can be used in some procedures. What the study was trying to do, was to examine the effects of xylitol consumption on platelet responsiveness and therefore platelets' ability to cause thrombosis. So among the 3,000 participants, one third of those patients with the highest plasma level of xylitol had an elevated likelihood of experiencing a cardiovascular event. And so the study's authors found, their conclusion was that consumption of products containing xylitol compared to glucose significantly raised platelet responsiveness in all participants, and therefore the use of xylitol could contribute to thrombosis, heart attack, and stroke.
How much xylitol, and were there confounding factors there? How reliable is this study?
Well, I was hoping you'd say that, okay? Because past studies have demonstrated that both xylitol, and I know you're not going to like it, Pam, I'm going to say the word, erythritol.
You know I love me some erythritol. Don't mess with me and erythritol. Love erythritol.
Folks, if we didn't know each other so well, you'd say we were married, right? I mean, I'm...
Finish each other's sentences.
Xylitol and erythritol can increase platelet aggregation. There, I said it.
No. I love both of those.
Well, the combined effects of xylitol and erythritol on platelet activity and therefore cardiovascular health indicate a concerning trend because both of these substitutes that are sugar substitutes appear to enhance platelet aggregation and therefore thrombus formation. And again, that's critical in developing a heart attack or a stroke. But so all the study tried to show was that you need to underscore the need for caution when we recommend these products, because people who are not at risk for, you know, pre-existing cardiovascular disease probably don't need to worry, but patients who are at increased risk may have to worry. Now, the study itself, it's important to note this, showed an association, not causation. So a direct link between the sugar substitutes and cardiovascular events was not established. That's huge, okay? If you don't read the details matter, right? In addition, this is according to a response by the Calorie Control Council, which is a trade association that represents the low and reduced calorie food and beverage industry. They said these results may not apply to the general population because some people in the study already had a higher risk of being predisposed to problems with their heart and blood vessels. And of course, you know the next line, because it's always the next line in every study. Further research is needed to elucidate the long-term effects of sugar substitutes on cardiovascular health. And so while sugar substitutes like xylitol and erythritol offer benefits in terms of calorie reduction and glycemic control, evidence suggests that they may pose cardiovascular risks due to increased platelet activity and thrombus formation.
So what about the topical use of these? For example, I know, you know, you can ingest both of them. You can also use them, you know, kind of topically, toothpaste, you know, airflow. I mean, there's a lot of different places that we're seeing the, you know, the therapeutic use, but they're not necessarily ingesting high quantities. Is this inconclusive study going to change how we practice? Because it might change how some people practice. I just feel like I need something a little bit more. I wouldn't, even for caries management, we recommend 6 to 10 grams a day of intraoral contact. It's not necessarily you need to scoop it and eat it in your mouth. I mean, it's one of the better, safer alternatives for caries management to, you know, reduce the risk of the pathogenicity of the bacteria. So are we just going to stop it? Like, what are we going to do?
I don't think this is ultimately going to change our strategy in dentistry, because we're waiting to hear from organizations like the American Dental Association, the Academy of General Dentistry, the leaders in the industry as to what to do with xylitol. There's been some talk and there's been some chatter back and forth, but quite frankly, as you said, xylitol is one of the things we rely on for caries management. It's one of the things we rely on for treating xerostomia. And it's ultimately, xylitol can cause some GI issues in high doses. So people don't necessarily like to use it at very high doses anyway, but it does open our eyes a little bit to the fact that there is this axis that we sometimes leave unexplored between medicine and dentistry. And that sometimes, you know, as I've said many times in my lectures, to be a dental professional these days, you've got to be an expert in the medical side of dentistry and the dental side of medicine, because the two intersect. And if you're not cognizant of that, then that can lead to bad things. And this is a good example of that. You know, us recommending the use of xylitol for our purposes, not realizing that on the medical side, it can have effects on patients up to and including increasing cardiovascular health risks in patients who are predisposed to issues with their platelets.
Okay, so long story short, we need more information. Probably not going to change how we practice at this moment. I like that we're talking about it because it certainly increases awareness and everybody should be up to date on what's going on, good, bad, and different. So I think that that's really helpful. But we need more information at the end of the day.
As always, yes. So thank you for the opportunity, Ben, to bring it up, because it's something that I'm sure is of interest and concern to a lot of our listeners. And I just wanted to make sure that I followed that the study as closely as I could, so that way you knew exactly what was said and what wasn't said.
Absolutely. And especially when our patients ask us, we can't be, I never heard of that. What are you talking about? So we need to be ahead of our patients. So thank you for sharing this and increasing the awareness. And everybody, for Medical History Mysteries, we will see you next week.
Take care, everybody.